In part 1, we talked about P&ID symbols within ISA 5.1 and checked out this column of the table for physical instrumentation symbols. We started to draw a P&ID based on an actual example from the industry to learn these instrument symbols in practice. I showed you how to demonstrate the electric motor winding temperature sensors and their transducers in the P&ID. We're not done with this part yet. As the ball mill electric motor is controlled by a variable speed drive, or VSD, I decided to connect its temperature transducers directly to the VSD. Therefore, I will do so in the P&ID and first consider the VSD and then connect the transducers to that. But I also want to send the signals from these transducers to a PLC card to show the real-time temperature of the motor to the operators in a monitoring system, or let's say human-machine interface. I will send them via the network between the VSD and PLC. In this way, through the human-machine interface, or HMI, if the operator opens the related pages for the ball mill motor, he or she should observe the motor winding temperature indicators. Inside the P&ID, I use a circle in a square symbol to indicate that the operator will see those temperatures on his or her computer in real time. In other words, each of these symbols in our P&ID equals one of these temperatures in the HMI. But why and how did I choose this symbol among the other 20 symbols in this table? Honestly, you might not get clear data out of this table unless you read the whole ISA 5.1 document. Therefore, I will summarize the most important points of this table during and at the end of this video. You should already know that these dashed lines are used for electric signals or electrical connections. But to show the communication links or a network bus between the devices and HMI objects, we should use this type of connection line. The VFD sends us some other pieces of data, such as: is it turned on or off? Is there a fault with the VSD? Is it running the motor at the moment? What is the motor's real-time speed? But the VSD also receives some signals and data from the control system, like the start and stop commands. Although the VSDs are provided with physical start and stop push buttons, we might want to command the motor to start or stop remotely via the HMI as well. Here in the table, you see this symbol within the category of shared display, shared control. Shared display means that we have shared some data with the operator in the HMI. And shared control means we have shared some controls there in the HMI. There is a very important point that I want you to listen to carefully. Some instructors might tell you that if your automation system is based on decentralized control system, or DCS, you should use the circle in a square symbol for a shared control or shared display object, or both of them. And if your control system is PLC-based, then you have to use a diamond in a square symbol. Even though this idea was true for older versions of P&IDs that were designed according to previous versions of the ISA document, it is not correct anymore. As stated on pages 10 and 11 of the ISA document, this definition is no longer acceptable. Whether a DCS or PLC control system is operating your plant, you can employ a circle in a square symbol for the shared control and shared display objects, and use the diamond in a square as an alternative, or in case of safety instrumented systems or emergency shutdown systems. The other piece of data that VSD should receive from the control system is the motor speed reference. The operator will enter the desired speed in the human-machine interface. This speed reference will be processed in the PLC logic and through a high-speed analog output card will be sent to the VSD. Now, let's talk about the solenoid valve, which opens or closes the grease supply to the bearings of the ball mill. The PLC programmer should write the program to link the opening or closing of this valve to the status of the electric motor. So, the PLC logic will open the valve via a digital output card. To know if the valve has executed the open and close commands, it should have open and close switches mounted on its actuator. Therefore, upon starting the motor, the grease valve gets open, and its signal will be transferred to the HMI via a PLC digital input card. The same thing will happen when the motor turns off, and subsequently, the valve gets closed. I used bubbles for the switches as they are field mounted. The nomenclatures I used inside the symbols are according to this table. ZSC, for example, is for position, switch, closed. Let's move on to another part of the drawing in which we have these vibration sensors on the bearings. These vibration sensors are connected to a locally mounted condition monitoring device. If I open up its box, it has a display that shows real-time vibrations of the machine. It also provides us with some outputs that, using them, we can send out these vibration signals to the PLC and indicate them on the HMI. So it actually acts like a transmitter with a local display. And if I want to choose a symbol for this device, I prefer this one as it is located in the field, but it has a shared display that is not visible to the operator unless he or she removes the cover. Here seems an appropriate spot for this symbol, and I connect the vibration elements to that. I want to turn off the motor automatically whenever the vibration of the machine on either of its bearings exceeds the critical limits. So, I directly send a signal from the vibration transmitter to the VSD to do so. I will also send it over to the PLC and operating station via an analog input card to notify the operator about the reason for the shutdown. VAH is short for Vibration Alarm High. We are almost done with this P&ID, except for some details, like the same vibration scenario for the electric motor itself, and sending these temperature transmitters to the PLC and OS. I also write some notes beside the drawing for more clarity. Now, let's review the P&ID symbols from ISA 5.1 to better categorize them in your mind. These are the P&ID symbols that you'll see frequently. We already discussed some of them, and we'll check the others in other P&IDs. Here, we have four symbol categories. Symbols for physical devices, which we have discussed in the previous part. Symbols for software objects and program logic. Safety instrumented systems or emergency shutdown system. And finally, shared display and or shared control objects. If generally there is a line inside a symbol, it is located inside or on a panel or console, whether it is a main panel or a local or secondary panel. If there is no line inside, then there is no cabinet or panel. If there is a dashed line inside a symbol, that instrument or device is not directly accessible to the operator. If there is a solid line inside, that object is accessible. In the next parts, we will discuss other examples to show the actual applications of other symbols to further deepen your knowledge about P&IDs.